back at Rangitata, 14th of December, more or less a week after the big deluge. It had this highway closed, detours allowed to show. Further up, Rundle, their access was cut off. This access here on Rangitata Bridge was cut off. So we've got a beautifully, very warm, dry, winded day here in South Canterbury. Let's take a squiz through and see what's going on. Last week, more or less about here, as far as I could get through, and then done it on feet. This first bridge, this had another river highly flowing under it, so from here it'll give you a good idea back to the main line. Still actually got a bit of a flow in there. River's made another vein by the look of that. A lot of boulders there. Slow trip of boulders, 3-4 rocks at a time in a truck. All the South Canterbury earth movers. Waldron, Paul Smith, you can see. This part up here, after flashing lights, this was absolutely inundated. There's one patch. Amount of silt and shit just there on the side of the road. Let's take a look over the top of the bridge and come back and go up the feet. So here we are underneath the Rangitata Bridge. It's a little bit quieter in the rapids today. Move up to where I was the other day, but just noticing something here on the bridge. Don't know whether this has been spotted, but right here on the southern end, she's showing signs of breakage. So we'll go back down there into Rangitata.
So here I am, back down at the Geraldine turn off of State Highway 1, where the other day this is absolutely chock-a-block. Detour was heading up here, but still in this area was underwater. So you can see they've already cleaned up this area, repacked the old railway line, and that's where the old vein decided to come through here and undermine the railway line. Here we go, back to the first bridge if you're heading north from Rangitata. Still got a good flow going through there. Steady. Amazing how much soil, topsoil, everything's been washed out. Just gouges its way through. So, as I said on the last video, this is a long way from the main river, which is right over there in the tree line. We are at the old battery shed here, G shed. Been there for bloody years, God knows what's in there, but anyway, north side of it. Here we got the yard where we got Simon Waldron, Paul Smith, good old South Canterbury earth movers, all the bloody diggers, all the equipment, and they're doing a bloody good job. And I must say, it's bloody warm up here. Dry winds, dusty as shit, but they're in there getting it all back together. So yeah, this is a huge part of getting the railway back together. I don't know, a kilometre of it just absolutely arsehole undermined. As you can see, remove the section, should be going up there. It now lays over there.